Emmanuel. If you know that your God is great, and great is faithfulness, say thank you, Jesus. Can I hear you say Emmanuel? Hallelujah. You may be seated. Viewers all over the world, thank you for joining us. By the special grace of God, I am here to share with you the message that has been given to me by my father and the Lord, Prophet T.B. Joshua. I believe you will be blessed, healed, and saved as you listen to this message in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every person you meet today is trying to change their life in some way. They desire excellence. They want financial freedom. They hate loneliness. And they want their health to improve. Every alcoholic hates his bondage. Every cancer or HIV/AIDS patient wants to be healed. Every afflicted person wants to be cured. They want to change their lives in some way, but they just don't know how. They want to accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior, and they are waiting for us for a lifetime. Will you be available? Ask your neighbor, will you be available? They want to accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior, and are waiting for us for a lifetime. The question is this: what do they really need to see in us before they can be changed from whom they are to whom God really wants them to be? This very question shall bring us to today's message titled Positive Examples. Tell your neighbor, positive examples. I have a message for you. I can't hear you. Say, I have a message for you, neighbor. Titled Positive Examples. Let's quickly read our proof text, taken from the book of Matthew, chapter 5. And let us read from verse 17 to verse 20. Are you there? Do not think that I came to destroy the law or the prophets. I did not come to destroy, but to fulfill. Verse 18. For assuredly, I say to you, till heaven and earth pass away, one jot or one tittle will by no means pass from the law till all is fulfilled. Matthew chapter 5, we are continuing from verse 19. Whosoever therefore breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches men so shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does and teaches them, he shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Once again, I take it from verse 19. Whoever therefore breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches men so shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does and teaches them, he shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Verse 20. For I say to you that unless your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, you will by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. Our message, positive examples. We are taught here that by his positive example, Jesus Christ came to correct evil acts. Anywhere Jesus Christ was, he stood against evil. Not just by his words, but also by his deeds. That was what he was born for. That was what he lived for. That was what he died for. Resurrected for. Sent back the Holy Spirit for. And that is what he wants us to live for. Today, it is very easy to point out the wrongs in the life of your friends. But it takes a lifetime to do what is right, to change the wrongs you see in that person's life. Mind you, if you are a servant of the Spirit of God, it means that you are made a channel of righteousness where there is sin. If you are made a servant of the Spirit of God, it means that you are made a channel of righteousness where there is sin. It means that you are made a channel of solution where there is problem. Since your life is a solution to a problem as a child of God, may I ask you, how many people's problems have you solved? Remember, a little example can have a big influence. The Bible says that positive examples are tremendous motivators for success. Just as negative examples are tremendous motivators for failure. Are you a child of God? Many have fallen today because of being influenced by people who set a bad example. We don't need to remind ourselves of the young ones who have been affected by the failures of their parents or the companies that have been seriously affected by the mismanagement of their CEOs. All of us have had a father, a friend, a mentor, or a teacher. But not all of us have had a father, a friend, a mentor, or a teacher that we wanted to be like. This ought to motivate us to seek out for a worthy example. You may have been looking for an example to follow, but I'm here to tell you that Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, is the worthy example. When we have a relationship with Jesus Christ, we will change and become men or women who are directed by the Holy Spirit, not by the influence of others. Only then are we Christians who live by positive examples. Now, may I ask you, are you a Christian? If yes, have you ever seen anything wrong in what someone else was doing? How best did you or do you correct the person in a Christian way? How best do you honor Jesus Christ in your correction? Is it by speaking negatively against a person without care and love? Have you ever sometimes find yourself judging and condemning others without striving to do what is right to change the bad you see in a person. If you find yourself condemning other people, permit me to ask you this question. Have you ever asked yourself, am I practicing what I preach? I have often asked myself these questions. Am I too quick to point out other people's wrongs? Other people's wrongs without doing or striving to change the bad I see in them? Am I a fault finder who does not provide a solution? What must I do when I see my neighbors acting wrongly? If we take our time to ask Joseph in the book of Genesis, chapter 50, take your reading from verse 15 to 21, he would tell us that his positive examples were tremendous motivators for his brother's success in a strange land. As God's servant, Joseph loved his brothers, but hated sin. As Christians, we should hate the act, but not the people, because sinners can be delivered and changed. Remember, you were once a sinner, and by the grace of God, look at what you have become today. You have become a changed person because you had the opportunity. If opportunity is given to sinners, they can be converted and changed. Don't forget what my father in the Lord, Prophet T.B. Joshua, usually say, that one good can cancel a million wrongs. Let us be known as people who are for good and not only against bad. Brethren in Christ Jesus, instead of criticizing our sick society, instead of criticizing our fellow men or our sick society, we should do what is good to change the bad we see. Instead of just being against poverty, please make a tangible contribution in the life of someone who needs help. Look around you, the orphans, the widows, the poor are around you everywhere. In your office, in your community, in your village. Instead of being against poverty, we should make a tangible contribution to the life of someone who needs help. Remember, your life is a solution, and your confession solves problems. If your life is a solution and your confession solves problems, may I ask you, how many people's problems have you solved in life? Positive examples have positive influences. The Bible says, by doing good and by speaking positively, you will not only revive the situation, but also you will silence the ignorance of your neighbors. As in the book of Colossians, chapter 4, from verses 5 to 6. When you speak negatively about a situation, you are worsening the situation, and you are not ready to revive it. Your words are capable of bringing bringing blessings, I mean bringing you blessings or denying you of blessings. The word you speak determines the kind of life you enjoy. The words you speak determine the kind of life you enjoy. What kind of life are you enjoying now? And what kind of life do you want to enjoy in future? This means that your words are the bridge to your future. Tell your neighbor your words. Can I hear you say it loudly? Say your words are the bridge to your future. Talk to somebody. Say your words are the bridge to your future. Now, let's take for instance. Wars. We have been hearing wars everywhere. War in this country, war in this community, war against this religion, war against that religion. Listen. Wars or fights begin because of words. Friendship begins because of words. Your words are capable of drawing people towards you or driving people away from you. Your words reveal the kind of heart you possess because they are the revealer of your belief. As a child of God, your words, your thoughts, and your deeds, I mean your actions, must reflect what you believe in the face of temptation. Remember the case of Jesus when he was tested in wilderness. Jesus Christ was at all points tempted, yet he was without sin. The word of God does not work on its own or by itself. We make it work by the way we live it, and God makes it good. As children of God, we must learn to do good at all times, because God is good all the time. We must learn to love God at all times because God loves us at all times. Do we? The answer is no. Yesterday, man was his brother's keeper, but today, man is his brother's destroyer. For example, in the past, your neighbor would wake up and be interested in your welfare, irrespective of religion or background, by saying, "Good morning, how are you?" But today, such things no longer exist because of what? Today, such things no longer exist. We have become strange bedfellows. Two people sleeping together, living together, have become strangers to each other because of religious, economic, political, or cultural reasons. However, in the book of Luke chapter 10, from verse 30 to 37, Christians are taught by Jesus that they should love irrespective of religion, ethnicity, or geographical location. With this kind of love, Jesus said to us in Luke chapter 24, Luke chapter 34, Jesus told us in the book of Luke chapter 34, Luke chapter 24 verse 34, that Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. By this, we have become successful people today. As sinners, this becomes the positive motivator for our success today. Indeed, positive examples are tremendous motivators for success. I leave you with Jesus. Stay with him.